The Parliamentary Select Committee investigating alleged mismanagement at Uganda Telecom will soon travel to Libya in line with the inquiry. The MPs will interface with some of the company's board members who live in Libya and also perform other duties connected to the probe.
We intend now to move because the 5 board members are not able to come to Uganda according to the information we have got. So we have written to them and the committee will be traveling to Dubai, and if we need, it needs be also to Tripoli to make sure we meet all the board members and they give us their version of how UTL has been operating.
Lap Green, a subsidiary of Libyan Post Telecommunication and Information Technology Holding Company, owns 69% majority shareholding in the Uganda Telecom, while the Uganda government holds the minority 31%. Uganda Telecom has for long been in a financial crisis, and there are claims that the Libyans are seeking to sell its shares to a US-based investor. Last week, the committee toured the UTL assets in Mukono and Toro districts and found that some of the company land had been sold off illegally. The MPs are also expected to meet the Prime Minister, the Managing Director of National Social Security Fund, which UTL owes billions of shillings in unremitted employee benefits, the line ministries, and also interface with those who bought or leased UTL land.
We are intending to meet with those who have purchased properties of UTL. We intend to meet them and look at the due diligence process. If some of the properties of UTL has been, you know, purchased using the correct process, or there was some, you know, faulting of the process of procurement.
The committee chairman, Chua West MP Okino Jara, also told NTV that the MPs will also seek to understand why the number of UTL subscribers has dropped significantly over the years.
So let us look at the historical past first, what has been the problem, what has been the challenges, what has caused this company to almost collapse. Then we say, okay, now where do we address the issues first before we look at into the future?
Last year, senior UTL executives were barred from leaving the country as investigations began. The ban was later lifted. The probe committee recently found that UTL is indebted to the tune of 700 billion shillings. Suhail Mugavi, NTV.